Alrighty, so this is going to be on red bean dessert. You basically buy azuki red beans, which you can kind of see through the bag. You're going to buy, it's not candy, but actually sugar, one box of those. And then you're going to also buy tapioca. So you can get ones that are pretty small. I wrapped it up in here, but basically it's tapioca and they're pretty tiny. So basically you only need about a bit of beans. What you're going to do is you wash them briefly, and then you have them in water boiling, as you can see here. I put about, a cup, not that much, about enough to make it level. Let me see if I can stir it for you to see here. So you do put about that much in there, which is enough to fill the bottom of the pot. Now the key to making these, the red bean split, is to add a pinch of salt. I personally like sea salt, but any salt will do. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of salt, about that much, just gonna sprinkle it in there. And what I'm gonna do is keep boiling water. The tapioca, I'm gonna put a bit of it into a bowl and add water. And then when this is close to nearly finished, what will happen is we'll add it at that time, as well as the rock sugar. So basically you're letting this boil for a good hour or so, stirring it, turning down the heat as necessary, and it'll basically fill the entire pot right to about there. So it's pretty exciting, and I'm looking forward to showing you the next stage. Alrighty, so this is just to show you how it's boiling along really nicely, and the water is sort of reddish brownish, so it's good to just kind of stir it, and it should not be sticking to the bottom. Preferably you're using a non-stick pot. Now the good news is that the beans, for about one pack, because usually it comes in a pack and it says azuki, A-Z-U-K-I, it's usually about $1, and the tapioca is about $1, and the rock sugar is also only $1. So this dessert pretty much costs you only $3. It's great to eat it cold or hot. I personally prefer it cold because I don't like to nuke things. And I've been taking it to work for breakfast, and it's so yummy. And the good thing about red beans is that they're great in fiber and iron and some other nutrients, I'm sure. You can look it up online on the Wikipedia website. And hopefully it'll be done soon. Well, it'll take another hour and a half or so. So this dessert really won't be done till about, I guess, 3 o'clock or so, depending on how much you like it. If you have a slow cooker, it is a lot easier to just throw the beans in, throw the water in, and it nicely, slowly cooks, and the starches from the beans kind of emulsify, and it's all yummy. In addition to that, of course, what a lot of Asian restaurants do is that they'll give you, you know, crushed ice, a bit of sort of this nicely evaporated milk with the red beans, and then more evaporated milk on top and more crushed ice, and it's so good. I also went to the store, and I know for Viet tea they have sort of this, whoops, I'm covering it, this sort of sweet condensed creamer. I think it's liquid. I'm hoping it's liquid. You can also use condensed milk. So when you go to those bubble tea places, which I know you frequent, they'll usually put like crushed ice. They'll put not so much the soup, but just the cooked red beans on top, and then they'll put sweetened condensed milk, which is like a syrup. It's also similar to that can I just showed you, and you eat it, and it is so good, and it's so yummy. So anyways, it's a good cheap dessert, and this pot easily lasts me a week. It probably only lasts in the fridge for about 7 days, otherwise it starts to stink. As a kid, actually, we used to take the soup or the dessert base and pour it in those little, those little popsicle trays, and actually they make great popsicles as well. You can also, if you don't add as much water, you can do more of a paste and put it into dessert rice flour ball dessert, which I hope to make using just rice flour. It's all doughy, and then you insert the paste inside, and so good. Anyway, so I'll be adding more water as it boils along. Eventually, when it becomes more glutinous, I will be turning down the heat to avoid it burning and sticking to the pot. But it is pretty delicious. And, oh, right. And I put the lid sort of like that. What is that? Half awake? No, wait. Slightly ajar? Anyways, this way the water doesn't escape as fast.
So, a bit of time has passed. And you can see that it's a bit more milky, if that's how you describe it. I consistently added about three sort of kettlefuls of water. You can see that the bean is fairly splittish, so it's very soft. I'm going to turn down the heat just a tad wee bit. You're always welcome to add more water because then you get more liquid into your system. I'm probably going to, not as much water because I don't think I can eat this much, or double this much in a week. But usually can add a bit more water and that way you have more soupiness. And so it's entirely up to you. When you go to restaurants, Chinese restaurants, and then they give you a free dessert, there's usually like 5 beans in the bowl and all liquids. Yeah, anyways, I'm gonna grab my tapioca while it's doing that. Alright, so I'm gonna grab your handy dandy tapioca. I prefer the small little ones because they tend to expand and are the size of the tapioca that you get in pudding. I need to go wash a bowl because apparently I don't have a clean one, so give me a moment. Alright, so I washed the bowl. and I only put this much tapioca, and the reason why is because last time I filled this bowl halfway, and the tapioca pretty much overtook the entire pot, because they do expand, like these jelly things. So I'm gonna, now to get tapioca to be ready, you add a bit of water. I'm gonna fill up the bowl all the way, there we go. And maybe to prevent flies from swimming in there, you just put a plate to cover it. And what you will find, by the time you're ready to pour this in, the tapioca would have expanded greatly, which is great. So you're going to put a little lid. And notice how, this is again $1. So, it costs even less than $3 to make this dessert. And it's nutritious and yummy. And I personally try not to put too much sugar because I find my face breaks out if I eat too much sugar. So hopefully that's not the case for you. So I tend to make mine a lot less sweet. And it's always easier to add less sugar than to remove a bunch of sugar. So I personally put this back in the fridge because of my fear of pantry bugs. There's this little filmy stuff, so I'm gonna scoop that out. And that way that's just something you're taught to do. Even with your slow cooker, you would do that. There you go. It's when I'm kind of swirling it around in here. You can see that there, it's coming along nicely. I'm probably gonna add a bit more water because I like mine a bit more soupy. There, and that's great, and that's quite a bit. It probably at this point is ready for the tapioca simply because the beans have split, the water's nice. It's been about what time did we start this? An hour and a half? It's been an hour and a half, so a lot of time has passed. So, actually, since I have already added the water, I'm gonna add sugar. Last time I added too much sugar, so I took it out. So, I put it in the freezer. So, I'm gonna grab some of that rock sugar, which I will show you in a moment. Usually about half the box is good, or more than half the box. It comes in sort of these chunky, ow! Okay. And that's hot. Okay. Oh my god, just a bit. Okay. Anyways, so I added 3 small chunks in there. But you can add, you probably end up adding, just show you this here. So, my last box. Da-da-da-da. Okay, so the rock candy does pretty much look the way it looks out there. And usually, what will happen is you'll have like a couple of chunks, So let me just show you. Alright, ta-da! Okay, so here's some raw sugar chunks. Now, you only really add this towards the end because it starts to make it even thicker and easier to burn once you add the sugar. But because I don't want to have to get up again, so it's about that big, and you can add about 4 chunk sizes of that. It depends on the sweetness level. I try not to make mine too sweet. Maybe I'll add 1 tiny one. But usually, usually it's like full, like really full. And last time I added about like that much of sugar. Actually, no, sorry, half of that much, just to make it less sweet. The tapioca, I probably could have soaked it earlier, so it'd be ready for now. But that's okay too. I don't want the tapioca to boil too long because it becomes jelly-like. Which is great. So anyways, I'm going to stir it in there. So the rock sugar, as you can sort of see there, it's just kind of nicely melting in there. And this sugar is not refined sugar. If you stick any other type of sugar, it does make this taste weird. I think a friend of mine put honey one time, it just tasted a bit strange. But anyways, you can see here that it's fairly split, which is nice. It's soft. It's coming along quite well. I'm probably going to leave the temperature. I might turn it down a bit, actually. Turn it just a little bit. The lid back on, and I'll probably come back in a few moments and add the tapioca.
Alright, so you'll see here that the tapioca greatly expanded, and if I let it sit a little bit longer, it would have expanded even more. So, and that only took about 10 minutes. So this will basically, I'm going to pour it right in there, this will basically help thicken the dessert itself. And there we go. Alright, so gonna just stir that in there. Here we go. So basically when the tapioca is thoroughly cooked, it will be completely translucent, clear. I think I still added too much. Oh well. I'm gonna turn down the heat because now with the sugar and the tapioca, this is likely to burn, especially if you're using non-stick. In fact, if you're using non-stick, you have to stir it more often than I did. So I've turned down the heat a bit and let it boil for another 15 minutes and then we'll be done. Okay, so I came back to it a few moments later and discovered that there are big clumps of jelly. So I stirred it a bit more. You can see that there's still specks of white, so I probably just want to boil it only a little bit longer. I turned down the heat down to 2, and you can hear water boiling in the background, just to hope to cut down the bonds of tapioca that are forming as a colony within the red bean dessert. So I will show you this, hopefully closer to when it's pretty much
done. Okay, so I'm going to turn down the heat because it's getting very gluten-y. So just to show you an example, so you're going to take that, and pour it right in there. Da-da-da. Hold on. Let me get another scoopful. This is definitely not ready because it's so soupy. So basically you would pour it in there, add a bit of the carnation milk, and it's done. So, hope you enjoy!
Alrighty, so I let the pot sit, because I forgot to mention you should really make sure it's cooled down. As I'm stirring this, alhamdulillah, I'm really happy to see that it's turned out quite nicely. As you see, the tapioca is fully translucent, those little bubbles there. I'm gonna pour some in here. Makes a great late night snack. Also, in Chinese, we call this tong sou, which literally means sugar water. Anyway, so I'm gonna put a little bit there. I'm gonna add the Z carnation milk. I turned off the heat. Last time when I did it, I kept boiling it to the point where the tapioca was translucent and it became one massive jelly. And then I refrigerated right away. And then it definitely became jellified. So this is definitely, alhamdulillah, a perfect batch. And I think my grandma would be proud, inshallah. Anyways, have a good dessert.